Запрошую до слова.
Now the floor is given to Colonel Гуцуляк, Ministry of Defense of Ukraine spokesperson on NATO-related issues. Good afternoon, everyone. Today's briefing, I would like to start with information. Yesterday, the President of Ukraine signed the law on the peculiarities of the state policy on ensuring the state sovereignty of Ukraine in the temporarily occupied territories in the Donetsk and Lugansk oblasts. The President of Ukraine, Supreme Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of Ukraine, Petro Poroshenko, ordered the Minister of Defense and the Head of General Staff of the Armed Forces of Ukraine in the shortest period of time to submit relative proposals concerning the change of format to implement this law, to propose the candidature of the commander of the joint forces, to present proposals concerning provisions on joint operative headquarters, to present strategy of the use of armed forces and the other components of defense, and also to carry out acceptance in the subordination of the commander of the joint forces of designated forces and means from other components of security and defense forces. Head of state emphasized that this law qualifies Russian state as aggressor state, and it is fixed in legislature. And in this law, legally, they identify that this is Russian Federation that occupied our territory. And this law significantly reinforces legal basis for the use of armed forces of Ukraine and other defense bodies in order to defend our state. And the president said that this law does not violate any international obligations of Ukraine, including the Minsk agreements, as Russia wants to present it now. The head of state stressed that Ukraine remains committed to the peaceful settlement of the problem of liberation of the occupied territories. And now about the situation in the ATO zone. During the last 24 hours, the Russian occupation forces continued to deliver fire at the positions of our forces. The enemy actively used mortars and artillery of prohibited calibers, especially in the region of Svetlodarsk Bulge. In the Lugansk sector, the occupants 10 times opened fire at our positions. And the hottest area was the region of Troitsk. Here, the enemy delivered fire at our positions with the use of mortars of 82 and 120 millimeter of caliber, artillery systems of 100 and 122 millimeter of caliber, weaponry of IFVs and grenade launchers, and anti-aircraft Zu-23-2. And our positions near Katerinovka, Krymska, and Svetlodarsk came under enemy shelling. The enemy used mortars of 82 millimeter of caliber, weaponry of IFVs, anti-aircraft complexes, anti-tank missile complexes, grenade launchers, and small arms of different caliber. On the whole, in the sector, the enemy launched artillery shells and 82 mines of different caliber. In the Donetsk sector, during the last 24 hours, the enemy 5 times opened fire at the defense positions of the armed forces of Ukraine, including with the weapons that are prohibited by the Minsk agreements. And the enemy used 120-millimeter mortars against our positions near Lebedinske and Lamakine. And the enemy also used mortars of 82 millimeter of caliber, IFVs weaponry, and large caliber machine guns. These shellings were recorded near Pisky. One more shelling of Ukrainian positions with the use of automated mounted grenade launcher was recorded in the region of Avdiivka. Out of 15 enemy shellings of our defense positions, 14 were identified as precision ones. And on the whole, in our direction, the enemy launched 8 artillery shells and 82 mines of 120 and 82 millimeter of caliber. In 3 instances, servicemen of the armed forces of Ukraine were forced to return fire using weapons that are not prohibited by the Minsk agreements. And unfortunately, we have casualties among our forces. Yesterday, in the course of provision of medical help to civilians in Lugansk Oblast, militants of Russian occupation forces shelled our medical workers. In the shelling, 23-year-old girl died, a doctor and serviceman who served in military service under contract. The leadership of the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine and armed forces of Ukraine ATO headquarters and all the servicemen express sincere condolences to the relatives of a medical nurse, the hero who courageously implemented her functions at the front line defending Ukraine against Russian aggression. And the result of enemy shelling, five Ukrainian servicemen were wounded and two were traumatized in action. They were all evacuated to medical institutions where they were provided with medical help. The state of health of one of the servicemen is heavy and others are in satisfactory condition. In accordance with information provided by the main intelligence department of MOD, Russian Cossack organizations continue activity at in the territory of occupied Donetsk Oblast, and they form so-called Azov Cossack forces. And Russian occupation command sees this as a reserve for so-called First Army Corps of Russian occupation forces in the Mariupol sector. So these Cossack hundreds are manned with local mercenaries and citizens of Russian Federation that have experience of military actions, and the majority of them are not fit for service in armed forces. And about other news, head of General Staff, Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of Ukraine, General of the Army of Ukraine, Viktor Muzhenko, met with representatives of the Council of Reservists. This is an advisory body recently created at the General Staff. The head of Council of Reservists, Junior Sergeant Taras Kalich, presented the provision on council that was recently developed, and the sides discussed the improvement of service in reserve, including legal improvements and especially the operative reserve of the first line. And also they discussed the improvement of the work of military commissariats and improvement of household conditions for servicemen during the meetings of reservists. And the side stated these meetings will become regular ones. And on the government portal today, they made public the information that the Cabinet of Ministers of Ukraine approved the decision to increase pensions for servicemen starting 1st January for about 1.5 thousand hryvnias. The decision was presented by Prime Minister of Ukraine Vladimir Groysman during today's meeting of the government. The Prime Minister stated that this decision do not require the introduction of changes to current legislation, and it will come into force till the moment of approval of a relative draft law that today is discussed at many platforms. Vladimir Groysman stated this is very important law. It establishes justice for servicemen, and today we take decision to increase pensions for servicemen, and on average it will be 1.5 thousand hryvnias, and they will start these actions immediately. So thank you. This is the end of